We all will accept that prices need to be determined by the free market. Even Keynesian economists or monetarists will say that the government shouldn't set the price of a particular good, that the free market, based on supply and demand, should discover what the correct price is. Well, interest rates are really just the price of money. And you can argue that that's probably the most important price in a free market economy, because money represents one half of every transaction. Yet when it comes to money, we set the price of money in this country the way the Soviet Union used to set the price of bread. We have bureaucrats at the Fed that basically fix the price, and they don't get it right. They generally fix it too low. And so as a result of pricing money wrong, pricing credit wrong, the economy's all screwed up. We have too much borrowing, we don't have enough savings, we have too much consumption, not enough production. Government is able to expand dramatically because the cost of paying for government through debt is lower. And so the whole economy is distorted because the Federal Reserve keeps interest rates too low. But we're never going to come out of this until interest rates are allowed to rise to a market level. The problem is, though, that the Federal Reserve wants to sustain the bubble. The Federal Reserve doesn't want to allow the short-term pain that would be necessary to cure the problem, even if it's going to cure it in the long run. Politically, you know, the pain is not acceptable to either party, so all we get is more stimulus. A good analogy would be of a drug addict. If you're addicted to a drug, and if you want to get healthy and get the drugs out of your system, you go into rehab. And in rehab, you have detox, you go cold turkey. And in the short run, it's a painful process not to take more drugs. But if you work through the program, and now you can be healthy. But we are addicted in the US to cheap money. And we need to wean ourselves off that. We need to go through withdrawal. We need to go cold turkey on this cheap money. But the Fed won't allow it, because the minute the economy starts to slow down, or people stop spending and start saving again, and now the economy contracts, the Fed wants to fight that off by giving us more stimulus. It'd be like if you went to rehab and every time you started to come off your high, they gave you some more drugs so that you would be high again. Well, it wouldn't be very effective, because you would never kick the habit. So what we need to do in the U.S. is recognize that the source of our problems is artificially low interest rates. It's not the solution. There is some transitionary pain, but the good news is it will be fleeting. It's not going to last forever. It's like with a Band-Aid. You can rip it off slowly, or you can pull it off. I'd rather pull it off and get it out of the way.